the cry. Something triggers you, and the next minute you feel fear, shame, or perhaps like a failure. I can't do this, you hear in your mind. Your inner critic activated and cruel in its critique. Oh no, you think to yourself. I don't want to feel like this. Quick, what can I do? The mind runs through coping strategies. A drink, a smoke, a box of donuts. What will shove this emotion back down to the depths? I shouldn't feel like this. The cycle of shoulding begins. I should do this. I shouldn't do that. Shame builds like a black cloud encasing you in confusion and fear. You are back in child mind. Whatever the situation looks is ominous. A catastrophe. Overwhelm nibbles at you. Maybe it's anxiety and your chest tightens and panic robs you of oxygen. Maybe it's depression convincing you that it is hopeless. Maybe it is loneliness convincing you of your worthlessness. They cycle like vultures ready to pick you apart. You wonder, how will I get through this? Time seems to stop. You are lost in an endless void that seems inescapable. The tears come. The body shakes. You wail. You pray. Dear God, help me. The psychologists call it an emotional flashback. The spiritualists know it as trauma release and ego death. It tears you apart. It breaks you open. It reveals the terrified little girl or boy inside that was neglected, abandoned, or abused. The wound is exposed. The wound is purged, purified, and cleaned with every tear. This is what healing looks like. This is the call of the warrior. This is the work. Going into the worst of the worst inside of you so that it can be easily expressed, expunged, transmuted, and alchemized. You learn to show yourself love. The love you should have received. You learn to show yourself compassion. You learn to save your inner children one after another, and in so doing begin to grow, mature, ascend. Your awakening is underway. It is confusing and scary. You don't know where to turn or what is happening. You desperately search for answers. Why is this happening to me? You ask into the silence of another sleepless night. You look for God but see only darkness. You feel small. Like Alice in Wonderland, who is shrunk and is in a mad place. Maybe it was a twin flame. What is a twin flame? Maybe it was a kundalini. What is a kundalini? Maybe it's your spiritual awakening, your soul's call, your salvation. Then why does it feel like this? Surely something is wrong. In the wrong, there is right. Everything is in opposition. Paradigms are collapsing. Consciousness is shifting. You pick up your wounded child from a place where she or he was left. You tell them, "It's okay. I'm not going to let anyone hurt you again. I am going to protect you. I am going to comfort you. I am going to keep you safe." You carry them out of that room. You bring them home. You become more whole as the pieces of you once fractured fit back into place. You can breathe again. The journey back to self has begun.